Now we will talk about additional settings. All these buttons are here. Almost all of them have hotkeys. The first button is Render. The render in ZBrush is not bad. Here are its settings. You can assign various materials, you can make them yourself, and you can download them, since there are a lot of them. And if you click here, the render will be calculated. Now it's not configured. If you prefer to work in a large space, you can click the tab. This is almost the same as in Photoshop. You can open this panel, like this one. You can hide this panel. In short, you can customize them for yourself. Let's get back to this panel. Press P, the perspective is activated. Then, in order to show or hide the parameters of this perspective button, we need to hold down Alt and click on the object. In this case, all settings can be displayed in the workspace and in the same way they can be removed. Here I already set 45 degrees. I work in 3ds Max and I'm more familiar with 3ds Max perspective. If you also work in 3ds Max, then it's easier to check which field of view, that is, which viewing angle is set in 3ds Max. For this, Ctrl+C hotkey is the creation of the camera, and in the camera, you can see the value 45 degrees. Accordingly, we hold Alt, click here, this value appears, and we simply insert 45 here, thereby activating the perspective. Let's see what this affects. A larger view angle and accordingly a smaller one. I put 45. Sometimes it's convenient to work both in perspective and in orthography. That is when this button is not pressed. Then there will be orthography. There are different options. And if you choose a perspective view, it is more convenient to adjust the perspective in accordance with the program in which you work. I mean with that 3D package. Because it is more convenient to do something in some classic 3D editor and then to refine some details in a sculpting program such as ZBrush, but they use it in different ways. And the next is Shift+P hotkey. It turns on the floor. It is used to see the orientation of the model in the scene and to see whether it's in the center or not. Sometimes it's important. And since this object was created in ZBrush, it's a primitive, and accordingly it's already in the center. Next one is local. What the local is for. For example, if you rotate your view, the rotation occurs. The center of rotation is the current subtool, the current object. But if you sculpt at the same time, we need to click on Make Polymesh 3D here. Then such kind of rotation will be uncomfortable for you. If we activate local transformation, rotation will occur around the editable surface. We turn off the local and see the difference. Press F. We will get to this hotkey later. Here is its analog. So F is the approaching to available workspace. And the next button after local transformation is local symmetry. This is the addition to symmetry tool, which is located here. Hotkey is X. After we activate this tool, we can create symmetrical patterns. Carry out the symmetrical sculpting. I'll go to the top view now. It's easy to do it if you rotate and then hold Shift, or rotate with Shift held down. Thus, we activate the orthographic views, such as left, right, in front, from the back, at the top, and underneath. And now, being on the top, we see what is happening. That is, such a red symmetry point clearly appears. It allows us to sculpt symmetrically. But if we move our object from the center, if I press W, the move tool activates, and I move my object like this, and go back by pressing Q, or clicking on Drawing here, and then deactivate the local symmetry, the symmetry instrument starts to work the wrong way. Since the object is not in the center and the symmetry tool works, its axis is in this place and not here. And in order for the symmetry to be on the object, we need to activate local symmetry. And now we have it. You can make the symmetry radial either along the X, Y, Z axis, or you can turn on all the symmetries. Then this symmetry will work on all fronts, but more on that later. Let's look now at this button. If we rotate the view, then we rotate it around all the axes. If we hold down this button, the rotation will occur along the object. That is, we can view from the sides. It can be very convenient. So, I turn off symmetry X. So, now rotating, I carry out the rotation along the object. It's very convenient. Or if we have to view the object vertically, then we will activate the bottom axis. And frame, as I already said, the F hotkey is move, zoom, and rotate. And the next key combination, Shift F, this is our filling with the display of the grid. That is, we activate this button, and you can separately, independently from each other, turn off the grid and fill. Then, for the next button, we need a second subtool. And for that, I will go to Subtools menu. Here is the object that we have in the file now. I'll click Duplicate. Here it is duplicated. I press W and transfer the object. And now activate in transparency. This is the translucency of the object. We will see that another unselected object will be transparent. And then the second button, it becomes active only when this function is active. It allows us to activate or deactivate the transparency, or other transparency remains, to make it black and white. That is, without this function, the transparency will be like this. And with it on, the transparency will be ghostly, which is more convenient. This function is very convenient in itself. And the next one is the isolation mode, when only the selected object remains and other objects are temporarily hidden. And the last button is also very convenient. It activates with Shift X, hotkey. Objects come back the same way by clicking on this button. This is a separation of objects from each other. It's very convenient when you have multiple objects one above the other, or when you can find some objects in Subtool, and it's more convenient to click here, so that objects move away from each other, you find the detail you need, sculpt it, do something with it, and then move it back to its place. It will be easier to show you like this. I'll make another duplicate. These two subtools are located one above the other, and clicking on Expose, I didn't cancel the Expose, so now you will see it. I cancel it, and everything comes back to normal. Thus, I can correct something and bring it back. A very convenient function.